put this gland just to show you how to add the Velcro strip, which Velcro and buckram strip, which many people are asking about at the moment. That's the flap for the top of the gland, as you would normally do. What we need to do now is attach the buckram just to the flap of the gland. I use 3 centimetre length of buckram for mine, but before we do that, we need a strip of waste fabric to prevent the buckram from sticking to the front of the fabric. So if we just lay that on the front of the fabric like so, with the flap flapping at the top here, then what you need to do is position and size your piece of buckram on top, fold over the top, go to the sides, make sure it's the right width, fold it in, gives you the width, and then slip it into the edges of your flap, like so. Just chop a piece of that off. Slip that in there. Then turn over your fabric, leaving your waist strip, face fabric. Turn over your flap and push that nice and neatly into the top of the buckram. Stick a few pins in as you go across your table there. You want the buckram to be all the way into the top. Nice and tight, as you would occur to know any time using buckram, right into that crease. And of course, when you've ironed it in, you take out the piece of waste fabric. It's only sticking to the back. Now, many of you say, well, why won't you just use a single-sided buckram? The problem is the glue penetrates both sides regardless and it does stick. So it just seems easier to use a waste piece of fabric. I'm not going to stop this video at this point, I'm going to show you all the way through what I'm going to do. Right. So that's insufficiently enough to take the pins out now. Don't overdo it because you'll shrink your fabric if you're not careful. Check your corners to make sure they're in perfectly on the edges. And nice and tight. Don't move it until it's dry, until it's cooled down. Allow it to cool for a second or two. Okay, so now you've got your buckram fitted into the top of your blind. Remember, you've got your flap of fabric here, stop and stick into the face. Allow that to cool for a second or two. And then what you would do is you would take to the machine. No, you wouldn't. You wouldn't. Once you've done that, using your trusted double-sided sticky tape, put that a centimetre or so below the top. It's very strong, this tape is, so you'll need scissors. Remove the top. Get your Velcro and stick close to the top. This is going literally a millimetre off the top. The buckram is pushed right into the crease, so the Velcro is stuck right a millimetre to the top. use a good strong, there's a link below the video to the tape. So, we now have the flap, and obviously it's not stuck to the face fabric much, but it is stuck to this. So take off your waist fabric, and you're now left with your flap with the Velcro on the tape. Take to the machine, sew only the flap, sew the Velcro on to the flap only, and once completed, when you're sewing that down so it's nice and tight, just fold under. When you've got your linings in, just fold the bottom under, like so, slip stitch across, and then you'll have a perfect crisp velcroed line that doesn't show through at the front. Okay.